In this video, we're going to go through how to push all of these form responses into a SharePoint list. So first things first, we need to find a team that we can house the SharePoint list in. I'm just going with my demo team. So I click on to files, this can be in any channel, and then open in SharePoint. If you can't see open for SharePoint, look for three dots, click onto that, and you should see it there. So open in SharePoint. This then opens this team up here in SharePoint. Now, just quickly, my form is going to include some dates, and by default, any team that we create has a US date settings. So if you haven't already, I strongly recommend updating your team into the Australian time zone. To do that, you click on to Site Contents, and then Site Settings. From there, look for Regional Settings, and we need to update the locale from English United States to English Australia. Make sure that you scroll down and click on OK to save that. I've already done that. So what we need to do now is go back into Site Contents, and we actually need to go ahead and create a SharePoint list to put these responses into. So we click on New and List. And then I'm going to select Blank List. And so we give this list a name. I generally like to use the same name as my form, but it can be whatever you'd like. So you might say Training Expression of Interest Responses or similar. I untick Show Insight Navigation. If you leave that on, it'll just make that list a shortcut down the left-hand side, but we don't need that turned on for my example. And then click on to Create. That's now created this list with just a title. So what we need to do now is go through and add in the columns for every question that we've asked. So back into Site Contents, and then we'll find that list and right click and go to Settings. If we scroll down, we have a list of our columns. So we can see we've got title and we've got a few other fields that are hidden by default. What we want to do is click on Create Column to add some more. Now, the easiest thing to do now is have a copy of your form up next door. So whether you've got two screens or you're using one screen. So I'm just going to go ahead and do that so we can very quickly add in those column names. So column name. Our first question is topic, but in this particular form, I'm actually going to require that the person filling in the form has a LearnLink account and has been signed in. So your first question might actually be, what is your name? And therefore you'd create the column name as name. Because I'm making my person sign in, name will be captured when that person signs in. So I'm just going to call my first one name. We'll leave it as a single line of text, scroll down, and everything else just stays as is. So go OK. And we'll create another column. I want to capture the date that this form is submitted. So I'm going to go ahead and call my next column date submitted. And this is going to be a date and time value. And if we scroll down, I just want the date. I'm not fussed about the actual time. So scroll down, click on OK. And we're going to create another column. So this is now where I'm going to come through and copy in the fields. So the first one will be topic, single line of text, scroll through, click OK. Create column, date preference. And this one will be a date and time again. Click on OK. And the last one is comments. So I'm going to keep this as a single line of text. You could also have it as multiple lines of text if you'd like. If you do choose multiple lines of text, just note over here where it says specify the type of text. I generally prefer to keep it in plain text. But for this example, I'm going to keep it on single line of text. And OK. And that list is now done. What I will point out though is that we have got one required field, which is title. This is the default setting. So I'm not interested in having title in my list of columns. This is a reserved column and it's very difficult to change the name or even try and delete it. So what I do is I click onto title, and where it says require that this column contains information, I select no and click on OK. And if we scroll down, this is our view. So we've got a view of this particular list. If I click onto all items, I don't want title to show. So I'm just going to go ahead and untick title. And so what my columns will say is name, date submitted, topic, date preference, comments. I might want date submitted to be first, so I can go ahead there and change that from position 3 to position 2. Click on OK. And now we can see we've got date submitted, name, topic, date preference, and so on. The next step that we have to do now is go into Power Automate. So you can do that from directly within SharePoint here. We can click on those 9 dots and find Power Automate. And from there, we'll click on to Create. And this is going to be an automated cloud flow. So we can tell that because it's triggered by a particular event. And our event is our new form being submitted. So I'll click on to that. And it'll ask for your flow name. So we can use the same name as before, or it could be something else of your choice. And our trigger is when a new response is submitted. So we'll click on to that and then click Create. All right, so when a new response is submitted, so what we have to do is use the dropdown and find that particular form. Now, depending on where the form is saved is how you select it. So this list shows every single form that I've ever created. If I've created my form in a team, it won't appear in this list and I actually have to use the form ID. So what I'm going to do is use the form ID to show you how to do that. So we'll scroll all the way down to the bottom and then go to enter custom value. And now it's asking for the form ID. To get that form ID, we need to open up our form, and you do need to be an owner of the form in order to do this. Now, if we go up to our web address, we can see we've got a section that says form ID equals. What we need to do is copy the entire form ID onto our clipboard and then paste that into where it says form ID. Then we'll click onto new step. So once the form has been submitted, we now want to capture the data. So our next operation will be get response. So there you go, get response details. So we'll click onto that. And again, it's asking for the form ID. So what we'll do is we'll just go all the way down to the bottom where it's, all the way down to the bottom where it says enter custom value, and paste in that form ID there. Under response ID, we can select response ID from the previous step. So we can see when a new response is submitted, this is the ID relating to that particular response, and we want that to bring in the details. So we'll click onto that. And those are our first steps there. Now, the next two steps I'm going to go through are only if you're interested in capturing the date submitted and the person's name if they are logged into the form. If your form is public or you're asking them for their name, you can skip these next two steps. So the first step I'm going to add is to get the person's name. So we go plus new step, and this time we're looking for an operation that is get user profile. And we're looking for version 2. So they get the user profile. And then where it's asking for an email ID, this will be the email address of the person that submitted the form. So we'll click into there. And then down below, it shows us a list of options. So one of the options is the responder's email. Now note that this does need to be a valid LearnLink account. And if the person has signed into the form, it will be valid. The next step is to get the date submitted. Now, when we submit a form using Microsoft Forms, it actually sets it to a UTC time zone. So that's not Adelaide time zone. So what we need to do is actually convert that time into our time zone. So to do that, we click on New Step, Convert Time Zone. And we're looking for that first one. Now, base time, what time do we want to convert? So if we scroll down through our list of fields, the time zone that we want to convert is the submission time. What is the source time zone? So it was submitted in the UTC time zone. So we just scroll down to the middle where it says UTC. And then what's our destination time zone? This is the Adelaide time zone. So we'll scroll through and find our Adelaide time zone. And where it's got format string, we need to select a valid string type for our SharePoint list. And that valid string type is year, month, date. But it does need to be in a particular case. So it's four little y's dash two capital M's dash two little D's. Okay. And that so far is what we've got in our flow. So new responses come in, get the person's name, get their time zone. As I mentioned, if you don't care about the date submitted or making sure that somebody logs into your form, you can skip these two steps. Now, the next step is to actually go ahead and create that item in our list. So we can click on New Step. And this time we are looking for something that says Create Item. So there we go, the first one, SharePoint Create Item. And it's going to ask us for our site address. So this is the site address of the list that we just created. The easiest way to do this is to go back into Teams and click on Open in SharePoint. So Files, Open in SharePoint. And what we're doing now is going up into the web address, and just before it says slash shared documents, we're copying everything to the left of that. So we'll copy that, go back into our flow, and where it has site address, click on the drop down and click enter custom value. We're now going to paste that site address into that location. You know you've got it right if when you click on the drop down next to list name, you see your list there. So we can see we've got training expression of interest responses there. So I'll click onto that. And now what it'll do is it'll open up the rest of that item and we can see our column names. So date submitted, name, topic, date, preference, etc. So I'll click into date submitted. And now down the left-hand side, I can see there's my submission time, but this belongs to that first step. And I've got my new converted time. So we'll click onto converted time. Then name. What we're looking for is the person's name from that get user profile step. So we can scroll down in here. We've got given name, and I'm going to go ahead and press a space. And then we're going to find surname. There we go. Topic. So if we scroll all the way down to the bottom, we can select topic. Date preference isn't liking the date in the form, but that's okay. I'll come and fix that in a bit. And then comments, we can scroll all the way down to the bottom and pick up our comments there. So that's going ahead and it's mapping all of the form responses to the relevant columns. Now in date preference, it's looking for a valid date field. So I'll put in a conversion formula to make sure that that works. So what I'm going to try is go into date preference. We'll click on to expression and I'm looking for format date time. Open up my brackets and then I'm going to click on to dynamic content and we're going to scroll down and find our date preference. And then we need to press end, and just before the closed brackets, we'll press comma. And this is where we put in our date format. So it'll be a single open quote, year-mm-dd. And click on OK. And now we're going to click on to save. And now it's time to test this particular flow. So we'll click on to the back button. Go back to our form and press on preview. So I can see that this form's capturing my name. I would like a Teams training. My date preference is today. My comments is and we'll click on submit. Now back to that flow screen. If I click on reload this page, I can see that my flow has run and it has succeeded. So going back to our SharePoint list, and that was just through our open in SharePoint, site contents, and then select our train list, I can see that there's one item there. If I click onto that, that shows me my new line there, which is great. So each time we get a new response, that will keep adding to that list. Another tip I have is actually to add this list as a shortcut to your team. So going back into Teams, if I press the plus button next to files or any other tab, I can select SharePoint. So we'll go SharePoint, and I'm in my demo team. I can click onto lists. I can select my training list. I can untick post to the channel and press save. That now shows me my list directly there in Teams. And what I'll do now is quickly submit another form. And when I press on the reload button, we can see that my new response appears there. Now, SharePoint lists are great because if you accidentally go ahead and delete your form responses, these won't be deleted. The only way to delete these results is to actually click on the circles next to them and then press delete.